question is, a ship leaves on a long voyage. When it is 18 miles from the shore, a seaplane whose speed is 10 times that of the ship is sent to deliver mail. How far from the shore does the seaplane catch up with the ship? How far from the shore does the seaplane catch up with the ship? So what happens is, one ship is leaving from this shore to some other long voyage. So some people have got confused that 18 is from the reaching destination shore. It is not destination shore because 18 miles is not a long voyage. 18 miles is not a long voyage. So it can't be from the other end. It is only from this end. So the ship is starting from this end. It is going 18 miles earlier, and then the seaplane is starting and catching it up with it. So what happens is, this is the starting point of the ship. This is the starting point of the ship. This has gone up to this point. This has gone up to this point, and this is 18 miles. This is 18 miles. A seaplane starts from here. So this is the ship that is traveling. Ship is here now. A seaplane starts from here. It is also going to catch up with the ship. It catches up somewhere here. So this is seaplane. Seaplane starts from the shore and ship is moving like this. Now what happens is, the ship is going also like this. So the seaplane will be catching the ship somewhere here. We are only concerned about the distance traveled by the seaplane. Let this be D. If this is D, this gap is already 18. So automatically this will become D minus 18. Let the speed of the ship be, time taken for the ship from this point is same as seaplane from this point, let it be T. So S into T is the distance traveled by the ship. The seaplane is 10 times as fast as this will become 10S. Time taken is same. This is distance traveled by the seaplane, which will be D. Now, this is ST, this is 10ST means D will be equal to 10 times of this. So you can also make 10, so 10D minus 18, which will be equal. So D will be equal to 10D minus 180. D will be equal to 10D minus 180. 180 will come here, D will go there. So 9D will be equal to 180. D will be equal to 20. The answer is 20. This is the way of doing it. But you don't have to draw this diagram, you don't have to do all this working. Once you understand the question, the easier way of doing it is, see, I am only concerned about the distance traveled by the seaplane. Let it be D. The gap is already 18. See, what they say is, if the seaplane is 10 times as tall as ship means, compared to the seaplane, the ship will be 10 times as slow. So if the seaplane is moving D, the ship will move D by 10 because it's 10 times as slow. Now, you don't require this diagram, you don't require all this equation, automatically this will come here. So what happens is, 10D will be equal to 180 plus D, or 9D will be equal to 180, D will be equal to 20. This is the easier way of doing it. So no diagram required, not this equation is required. Once you draw this, this is the equation that is going to come. Just follow my channel, subscribe to my channel, it's free of cost. I'll be adding questions every now and then. Wish you all the best.